Mambo Italiano, hey Mambo, Mambo Italiano, go.
So what are we making today?
We're gonna make a bit of red wine. We go to the market where they sell the grapes for wine. There's one place where we're going to get the grapes near. Usually there's a truck stop. All the trucks stay up there. You know, when if you've got a semi-trailer, you know where to put it, just park it up there. But this time of the year, they use especially for all the grower come with a semi-trailer load of grapes and sell the grapes up there to the public.
I'm praying for rain in California so the grapes can grow and they can make more wine.
Shiraz, Shirazi, Solo, Mataro, I've got some cab over there as well.
In Chicago.
Where are you from?
Redmark, South Australia.
You drive here from South Australia with all your grapes?
Yeah. Should have been a comedian, shouldn't I?
There's
a semi over there. See the semi? Brought it down this morning, mate. I've slept 1 hour. I'm absolutely off my dial.
You better get him some sleep then.
Yeah, how am I? I'm gonna sell 2,000 boxes of grapes. Don't worry about it. All right, have
Charles.
See you later. Cheers.
So now what do we do?
So we pick it up, we go up there, and we crash it.
So how many bottles do you hope we're gonna make?
About 100 baht bottles. Actually, this one, it's partly, I made it. That was bought, but I put the wheels with the motor on. That's an old washing machine motor. Otherwise, before you had the handle, you crank with a, turn by hand.
Oh, mamma, mamma mia. Ho visto la sidella, sia vero quanto è bella, sia vero quanto è bella.
What do you have to do now?
I want to take this one so they make vinegar out of it.
So, how long do the grapes stay in that big tank?
In that vat up there? 5, 6 days, 7.
And so you don't add anything, that's just squashed grapes?
Nothing, absolutely nothing.
And so how does it ferment? What is...
Because the yeast which is built in the skin, what they call the wild yeast in the skin, it's makes it fermenting. That's the old traditional way we used to do back home and so on. But some people, what they do, they wash the grapes before they in the metabisulfite, which killed the wild yeast, and then they had their own yeast to it. But I prefer to do the old-fashioned way as Dad taught me to do it, which is you don't use any chemical, whatever. So the wine is it's pure as it can be. When Dad used to do it, he had a he built a cement.
A cement vat.
Yeah, and when you take the wine out, you got a stand in it. But because of the alcohol, you got to be careful because it may never come out of it. As the legend say, that Pope Pio Nono, he died in it. That's how he died there. And I remember when he stood with Dad, he used to go up there. And you got to stay for a few seconds, you got to get your head out because the carbon in there, the fume. And they say the way to test, put the candle over. If the candle dies, don't go in.
When we made the wine, we all waited in line with our feet scrubbed because we had to get into the wine with Auntie Lucy and all the aunties. And usually the girls, we were allowed to go in and chom, chom, chom. So we waited anxiously. You can't do the wine without the babies.
Well,
you've got to wake
them. Let's get the babies. Come on. Wake up. We've got to make the wine, kids. It's time to make the wine. Can you scrub your feet, please?
Check your nappies.
Alice, you've got to tuck your dress into your undies.
Do you want to go and play in there too?
Hey, yeah, we've got the new generation. Yes. Learn how to make wine.
Grapes.
Yeah, you're going to drink that.
Yeah, boom, boom.
Hope you washed your feet.
That's the continuation of the wine. Has been fermented. It's 7-8 days. Now we have to check. Every often use these little tools. You check the quantity of sugar.
The black line up here, that is the zero. That's what the water contains. If that's supposed to be, when there's water, that stay liquid like that. The difference then there is the amount of sugar still left in there, because the more alcohol there is in there, the higher the things come.
Yeah, I think now that's all right. It's ready to sort it out. Off we go.
When we finish saving all the wine, still there's some left in there, so we put them in here and we press them to get the last drop of wine out of it. This is leftover from my father-in-law, which a friend of his was working at the railway, and that's how I made it. This is an axle of the brakes of the carriage. And that's the bottom, it's all welded together, done. It's made it today. It's a lot of carbon monoxide, you can smell. Yeah, the press processing starts. You see how quick the wine starts to flow a bit stronger. Look at it. It stays in there, wet for a while, and after that, I put it back again in there. I got a stainless steel barrel, and we stay up there for another about probably 6 months before I bottle it. We put the lid on, and we seal it so that no air escape. That is locked in there. That hose is going there. And when the carbon in there, the carbon monoxide escape, go out, but no air going in to contaminate the wine. So it's, as the carbon converted the sugar into alcohol, the carbon monoxide come out, and then that's it. You've got to change a couple of times, change from one barrel to another, so you separate all the muck from underneath. Right? And then in about 6 months, it's ready to drink.
So you're just saying, just use any bottle with a screw, put the screw back on, and it's done?
And it's done, yeah, it's there. We, at the club, we buy the wine in a casks, like that, and I empty it, I get it home, and I fill it up with my own wine, and I go here. I can pick up one bottle, one glass, whatever I want up here. Like, I got this one that all with wine, full, that's white wine, red. If I want to use a glass, I come up here, yeah. I get only one glass of wine.
How's the wine? Is that the wine you made in March last year?
No, that's the wine that was made 2 years ago. This is 2 years. But I got a bottle up there about 4 years or longer in there. Because once you seal the bottles, very seldom go off. They can stay for a while.
Mambo, mambo Italiano, mambo, mambo Italiano, go, 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 you mixed up Sicilian.
You're not going to make it anymore?
I don't think so.
Why not?
It's just so much macaroni, and then it's cheaper to buy.